first Labour Day was celebrated by 1890 in Europe. The first time Workers' Day celebrated in Nigeria was 1981. Since then, Nigerian workers have been joining their counterparts across the globe to celebrate the International Labour Day in every 1st of May of the year. The essence of this day is to celebrate with the workers and laborers whose vital work keeps countries and businesses across the world running smoothly, and also to encourage them to be aware of their rights. Nigeria joined other nations of the world to commemorate the 2021 May Day celebration since 2019, as the 2020 edition was affected by the coronavirus pandemic. Celebration which took place at a traditional venue at the nation's capital, Eagle Square, Abuja. So many dignitaries from organized labor in attendance. Our reporter Tolulope Oludayo, who was at the Eagle Square, narrated that in spite of the COVID-19 measures put in place, it was evidently feasible that the 2021 Workers' Day celebration was well attended by various unions, associations, and groups of employees that made up of organized labor in Nigeria. Speaking jointly at the event, the President of Nigeria Labor Congress, NFC Comrade Ayuba Waba, and Comrade Peter Esele, President, Trade Union Congress, TUC, condemned the spate of insecurity arising from absence of job opportunities to Nigerians' youth and poor present working conditions of Nigerian workers. They, however, questioned the impact of security votes allocated to the state governor without its corresponding effect in the society.
The Nigerian banking sector has continued to see the difficulties of market reforms. The federal government has not ceased to assist to add the institution of total withdrawal of sources of petroleum products.
Many dignitaries who spoke with our reporters expressed their displeasure over the challenges facing Nigerian workers over the years and lamented that the situation has been unbearable for many years. They were clamoring for creating enabling environments for increase in the welfare package of the workers, for efficiency and creation of job opportunity for Timi population.
You look at the loss, you look at the predicament that workers are facing, and then you ruminate over how to try to mitigate the effect of the bad work condition, especially in Nigeria.
Well, the National Assembly has continued to assure us that the PIB will be passed. In fact, they mentioned the month of April. April has gone. But our agitation is that let the bill be passed so that the entire sector could be restructured for the interests of Nigerians and our economy.
Industry needs to be restructured in a way that rand pegs will be in round holes in health situations. Have health hospital administrators or health administrators at the ends of affairs of health institutions. But in the case of Nigeria, it's the other way around.
Been discussing about insecurity that is also affecting workers in Nigeria. We're also talking about slave wages that is being paid and the abuse of Labour Act, Trade Union Act by some governor. You can see that there is a linkage between deprivation of people and insecurity.
We should ensure that at least the struggle continues. We cannot relent. We should continue to demand for a better working environment. We should continue to demand for a better wages and salary wages, whereby we ourselves we can involve in these politics and determine what we can be paid, and we can be able to determine at least a better working condition for our workers.
Imagine after wasting or after investing such amount of money, you will now hand it over to someone who is taking 26,000 naira as his take home. How will he manage it well? Nigerian workers, railway workers are demoralized because the remuneration is very poor. So we've been struggling, but
challenges, of course, is a very bad thing in the nation. We should equally look at the wages of Nigerian workers, because 30,000 naira is no longer feasible, considering the situation at hand.
Tolu Oludayo, reporting for News Portal TV.